Hi everybody, it's been a while. I think it was 2 months now that I haven't done a video. I've been extra busy with her. We had to be training and did a lot of stuff. And now it's raining, so I think it's time for a new video. Today I'm gonna do an unboxing or unwrapping per se of an item I purchased to do some Bikejoring. So Bikejoring is pulled up with dog power, and she is gonna be one of them that's gonna pull. So what I ordered is through Alpine Outfitter, not sponsored, and I've ordered from them before and they've been very good, so I decided to give it a go. I had the choice between an antenna that goes at the front of the bike, and it basically holds the tug line into place, and that way it doesn't go inside the wheel and then you don't get into a wreck. It's just a lot safer. So it came in, I ordered a noodle. It's like basically a pool noodle, I think. It came in this little package here. I received it a couple days ago. I've been dying to open it up. So today we're opening it up together and the help of Shala here. Shala has been foster with me for a little while now. I think we're at 4 months. And she's done a lot of progresses. I'm really proud of her little face. And she's always curious of everything. And she's looking around. That's the first time in this area in my house, so she doesn't know what to think. So I had the choice of colors for this pool noodle. And it came in neon green and neon yellow. So this is the neon yellow one. And you can see their logo here, Alpine Outfitter. This is like basically what it is. It's just conduit insulation and a hole inside. So this little string, which I pulled too far, is to help guide your line through. So there it is. It's still there and there. So you attach the one side of your line and pull it through. And this bit is to attach to the handle of your bike. So then it stays at the front. And there's the instructions here. Noodle installation. It comes with this little packet here. Oh, and a thank you note. So I ordered a single line as well, because the one I have right now, it's a double, and I thought with the single line that would be easier. And here, this is to attach to your bike head. So you just turn it around like this in the front area, and then you clip your line to it here. And here is my one dog tug line here, and it comes with a bungee. So basically what the bungee does is when the dog just start pulling, it gives like a little bit of go, so it's all the energy is not transferred directly to the bike, and it gives a big tug. It's just a slow compressed tug here, and there's these two clips like so. And this goes around. I'll have to make a bike demo. I have a bike here next to me, so I'm gonna be able to use it. So this goes around the head tube of your bike. Then you slide this bit with the bungee closer to you inside the noodle. Then this attached to this, and this is attached to your handlebar area. There's a little loop here that you clip together, and this will keep the tug line away from your wheel. So that's the main goal of it. And then this part is attached to the dog harness. I should put it all together and then I can demonstrate how it is made together. Actually, never done it, so I'll have to figure it out as I go. So stay tuned. I'm gonna go get a dog harness and probably just demonstrate it with Shala, I guess, since she's here. So stay tuned. All right, so now it's installed. I used an old touring bike I had for a little while here, and needs a lot of fixing, I guess. And that was just what I had here. So this part goes to here, around the quill on this case. This is a quill, and you adjust it to the length of your line here with the pool noodle, or the noodle, whatever you want to call it. And with the help of that string that they provided here, you're able to slide your tug line inside here and attach this head tube thing. I don't know the actual term for it, like this, and then you put your tug line. So it inserts by where the attachment is to go to the bike here, and then the bungee cord inside where the tug line exits, and then Dramalama is sleeping on the job. I put the harness on it because Shala wanted to go upstairs. So that's another harness by Alpine Outfitter that I have. I have other brands too, but that's my first one I ever got. It was for my good old Taco that never really took on to doing this, but I have it, so why not? So the line ties to the string here and then runs all the way there. And what it does is exactly like it does here. It will go on the side here and leaving the line out of the wheel's way. So this is what's gonna go against it, I guess, if the tension is not there, but it allows the line to move both ways without having the actual tug line here go right in the wheel. To just prevent accident, I guess, if there's no tension on the line too. So I really like this contraption. I'll show you from the other setup here from the picture. So bikes with the quills, which is technically threaded, they cannot use the antenna, which I would like to get eventually. So my kick scooter is like this. It's got like the BMX style bars, and I need to have this kind of contraption to be able to use it. The antenna goes on a threadless, it sets, and there's like spacers that you remove and then you put the antenna onto its place. And it's basically the same concept but with just a metal stick basically, and then a little loop at the end where you put your line through. And it does the same kind of job, but for quill bikes like the one or this one here, good old bikes, that's what you need to have this safety device on it. So I won't be able to try it today, but I'm excited to have this little piece here. It's really well made. They have put a nylon cover on it, so it helps for the wear and tear of that insulation pipe of some sort. It's like for your hot water. But it's good. So it's well made, like so, all along here, nice seam. And their equipment is very good. I'm really pleased with it. My double tug line is by them too. I got it for Bikejoring and it's been really good so far. No problem whatsoever with it. And that harness have served me well too for the times I've used it for Taco. That one is made of a fleece, what's called like polar fleece, and around the rib cage as well. And then the X back section on the back there with the little strap here. And nice little hooks that you can remove if they're broken. So basically just pull it out. I'm going to try to do it one-handed. It might not go well, but this just slides out like so. Oops, sorry. Just like that, it slides out once this is done, so you can replace them if they break. And to put it back on, it's just as easy. Just like so. And there's this swivel, so it helps too, to not get things all bunched up and tangled. So that's pretty much it. So that's it, guys. That's the unwrapping of the noodle for bike jarring. That's a little bit different equipment that's needed compared to the sledding stuff, like the kick sled that I use in the winter time. Not a pro. I'm just getting into the sport, like really this year. I've done it a little bit before with some other dogs I had, like Paw Cooper, for example, and some Pyrenees. Now I'm doing it with Badger, which is a Nakbash, Kuvas and Pyrenees cross, and with Shala as well, which I don't know. She's Jack Russell of sorts. She's funny. And I tried it with Fiji, my little black dog, and she's not liking it so far. So we'll see. Shala, she's probably going to be the first one to test it, or even Badger. These two really enjoyed the sledding last winter, so hopefully they're going to enjoy that one too. I'm not sure if I'm going to try it with a bike first or my kick scooter. Whichever is the least dangerous, we'll say it that way. So I have a harness that's a little ill-fitted for Shala so far, but since she's a foster dog, she'll just use what I have because it's nothing competitive and she doesn't pull it that hard anyways. So I hope you like that equipment that I showed you today, my unwrapping, and stay tuned for the next video. If you have any questions, yes. If you have any questions, don't be shy, ask away. I'm gonna put the link in the description down below for Alpine Outfitters, where I got the noodle. And if you have any questions, please feel free to post them in the comments. I'll be happy to answer them. Thank you and stay tuned for the next video. Bye.